It's one of every space nerd's all-time favorite Apollo stories, the time Apollo 12 was struck not once, but twice by lightning on the way to the moon. So we're gonna look at what happened, really, today on Vintage Space. Apollo 12 launched for the moon on November 14th of 1969. And unlike every Apollo launch before it, manned and unmanned, this day dawned very cold, rainy, and cloudy in Florida. But no one considered scrubbing the launch. The Saturn V is a mammoth vehicle and beautifully engineered to do its job with backup systems and redundancies. There was no way that it would be taken down by a simple rainstorm. Well, it almost was. As the Saturn V tore through the electrically charged storm clouds, the rocket and its contrail acted like a lightning rod. It generated electricity and a spark and was struck by lightning twice. The crew on board, Pete Conrad, Al Bean, and Dick Gordon, hadn't seen what happened to their spacecraft, but they did see the effects. And it was the same story in Mission Control. They all saw the same thing, a complete disaster of telemetry.
The hell was that?
I lost a whole bunch of stuff.
I don't know. Some buses.
Mark 1 Bravo.
Roger, we had a whole bunch of buses drop off. There's nothing.
It's nothing. I think it's.
What we got? I can't see. There's nothing wrong. AC bus, one light, all the fuel cells.
I just lost the
platform.
All I got is EDC.
Yeah. Okay, we just lost the platform, gang. I don't know what happened here. We had everything in the world drop out.
I can't, there's nothing I can tell from wrong, Pete.
I got three fuel cell lights, an AC bus light, a fuel cell disconnect, AC bus overload, one and two, main bus A and B out.
I got AC.
You got AC?
Yeah.
Maybe just the indicator. What do you got in the main bus?
Main bus is supposed to be 24 volts.
Huh?
24 volts, which is low. We got a short on it of some kind, so I can't lose a volt.
On board the spacecraft and in Mission Control, no one knew what had happened, except one man, John Aaron, the 24-year-old ECOM working the launch. He recognized what had happened. The telemetry that he was seeing wasn't gibberish, it was a pattern and it was familiar. And from the recesses of his mind, he actually remembered where he'd seen it before. He'd seen the exact same nonsense data pop up during a simulation years earlier. In that instance, a test conductor had accidentally dropped the spacecraft's power system to low voltages, and it turned out that a low voltage had upset the signal conditioning equipment, a box of electronics responsible for translating information from onboard sensors into signals that fed the displays in the spacecraft and on the ground. In its normal setting, the SCE needed high voltage to accurately display data, but in the auxiliary setting, it could actually display correct data with a low voltage. And so Aaron sent the command over to Flight Director Jerry Griffin to tell the crew to turn SCE to aux. And no one knew what was going on.
Apollo 12 Houston, try SCE to auxiliary, over.
Try SCE to auxiliary. What the hell is that?
Fuel cell SCE, SCE to auxiliary.
Try the buses. Get the buses back in the line.
Everything looks good. SCE to aux.
But no one knew what the SCE switch was or where to find it. And again, it came down to one man, Al Bean, the lunar module pilot. He knew where that switch was, the crew flipped it into aux, and all the telemetry came back beautifully. Nothing had stopped the launch, and Pete Conrad hadn't aborted. Apollo 12 was still go for the moon. And, as is typical of the Apollo 12 crew if you read their transcript, they laughed over the incident all the way into orbit.
Well, okay, now we're figuring out our problems here. I don't know what happened. I'm not sure we can get hit by lightning. I think we need to do a little more all-weather testing.
Amen.
That PPO2, I want.
Hey, that's one of the better sims, believe me.
Yeah, a lot. I'll tell you what happened.
We got a couple of cardiac arrests down here, too, Pete.
There wasn't any signs for that up here.
S4B to orbit.
S4B to orbit.
Man, oh, man.
I was looking at this.
Houston, you're right smack dab on a trajectory. Your IU's doing a beautiful job.
Okay, we're all chuckling up here over the light. We all said there were so many on, we couldn't leave it.
You guys know Apollo 12 is my all-time favorite mission. I named my cat Pete Conrad because I loved Pete Conrad growing up. He was the astronaut that made me love the human side of space exploration. Do you have more questions about Apollo 12? Because this is a mission I know all the weird details about, like the tuna that Dick Gordon wanted to eat on the way to the moon, and also, when I talked to him about it, what he remembered about that instance, what, 45 years on? That's a good story. I do have a video about it right up here. Leave all your Apollo 12 questions or just Apollo era questions in the comment section below, as well as things you would like to see covered in future episodes. Be sure to follow me on Twitter and on Instagram for daily-ish, vintage space-ish content. And with new videos going up right here every single week, be sure to subscribe so you never miss an episode.